Hey, it's Mike here, and today, could high doses of B12 supplementation be giving vegans acne? We're going to look at studies on the mechanism at high versus low doses, and really there was an interesting study that came out somewhat recently looking at the microbiome of your face. We're going to look at that in detail, and I want to mention my intention is not to scare people away from taking B12 supplements. I still think they are great and necessary, just to highlight a potential uncommon result of high dose B12. Furthermore, that a lot of vegans are taking just way higher doses of B12 than they need to. We'll look at a study on that. And let's just get started. Looking at B12, it is from bacteria, and vegans in general are absolutely advised by pretty much every plant-based doctor I've ever known that they should be taking B12 in the form of oral supplements or be eating an adequate amount of fortified foods. And thankfully, the amount of fortified milk that people have been eating has clearly brought the deficiency rates down. From that recent study out of Switzerland, the vegans had no statistically significant higher rate of B12 deficiencies than the meat eaters. And another very relevant way that people get B12 is by injecting it, by taking B12 shots. Most of these are for weight loss, but some people are vegan and they decide, why not get a B12 shot? It should be the most effective way. And high doses in the form of B12 injections haven't been shown to be dangerous, so it's like, why not cover your bases? But there's dangerous, and then there's potentially causing acne in a small portion of people. And while the mechanism for this has only recently been studied in detail, and we'll get to that study in a second, it has been noted in the literature for decades. From this study from 1976, it had acne after high dose B12, then it faded with a short time after the supplementation was stopped. There was also a study from 1991. After B12 supplementation, they had a facial eruption, kind of serious terminology, but it promptly improved after supplementation was discontinued. You know, and reports of acne on the forehead and chin are echoed by this 2013 case study of acne after high-dose B12, you can get an idea. And as usual, it improved after the injection stopped. Now, because of the sheer amount of people that get B12 injections across the Western world, if it was a really common reaction, we would know, and we don't really see it. But this recent study, the main study we're going to be looking at, gave us an idea of the prevalence. They also explained why it might happen on a microscopic scale, once again going to that facial bacteria. So the study actually just looked at 10 people, and one of those 10 people had an acne response after getting B12 injections. So not huge. You might think, oh, that might just be a coincidence. We're going to explore that more in a second, but it's worth noting that they sort of hashed out the mechanism for this. They revealed that vitamin B12 supplementation in P. acnes, which is the strain of bacteria on your face which can cause acne, doesn't always. Those cultures promoted the production of porphyrins, which are known to induce inflammation in acne. And to really sum up the whole mechanism, the excess B12 in your system is exuded out your skin. The bacteria detects that B12, decides, I don't need to make B12 anymore, and because the precursors to B12 are the same as the precursors for making those porphyrins, they decide, might as well make some more porphyrins instead, which then leads to oxidative stress and inflammation and acne. Back to the one person who got acne, they took facial samples before and after giving them the B12 and giving them acne, and they said, quote, our study demonstrates that vitamin B12 supplementation in the host repressed vitamin B12 synthesis genes in P. acnes. So they have good evidence that what was happening on this person's face is also what they measured separately in a test tube, that the bacteria was making less B12 and instead making these harmful porphyrins. And this whole porphyrin thing really piqued my interest and led me down a pretty deep rabbit hole, and I'll give you a little bit of the rewards of that rabbit hole. First of all, interestingly, porphyrins glow under a black light. Now, so I was thinking maybe if you just took a black light, a UV lamp, and put it over somebody's face, you could tell whether or not they had an issue with porphyrins. And it turns out I'm a noob, and they've been doing this for a while, not with porphyrins in particular, but here's a whole paper on using black lights in dermatology. You know, it can detect things like vitiligo or fungal infections. And then we have this study that actually says it's a more objective method of assessing acne severity. You can see that that glow very much corresponds to the acne on the person's skin. So while it appears to be normal for this bacteria on your skin to produce some porphyrins, like maybe this picture is a normal rate, it's unclear. However, the more you have, if you have too much, then it's an issue. It's not exactly the kind of glowing skin that you want. And at the end of the rabbit hole, for whatever reason, it appears that people who are exposed to levels of radiation that are high actually exude some more of these porphyrins for whatever reason. So it might be a good indicator if someone was overexposed to radiation and need to be treated. Okay, tangent over. Let's get back to B12 supplementation. At this point, I think we need to ask, what is a higher dose B12 supplement? I see Probably the highest that people are taking regularly in oral pill form is 2,500 micrograms, which is 2.5 milligrams. When people are injected directly into their bloodstream, it's only about a milligram, at least according to this study. That injection directly into your bloodstream can lead to really high blood levels, way higher than if you were to just take a pill. It has to go through your digestive system. And as the study mentions, the level in your blood correlates to the level on your skin, so you're clearly exuding it. And those injection levels get to 1,500 to 57,000 picograms per milliliter of your blood when the normal range is like 200 to 900, and that lasts for about 2 weeks. So that's really high. What we don't know is if regularly, you know, daily taking those high doses of B12 orally can get your B12 skin levels up to a point enough that would actually influence your facial bacteria. We need more studies. From this study, we know that taking high levels of B12 orally is equivalent to getting B12 injections in terms of reversing blood abnormalities, but reversing blood abnormalities does not equate to influencing facial bacteria. We just don't know. In the meantime, we might as well ask, what dose is really necessary? Do people need to take high dose? And this brings me to this 2019 study, pretty recent, that actually took vegans with moderate deficiencies and gave them either only 50 micrograms per day, which is a really low dose, and a higher dose, and they found that they were both equally effective at getting them out of deficiency. Very worth noting. And in case you're skeptical, it did measure some of those more advanced biomarkers for B12 content in your body and found that yes, those went up too. But let's think for a second about what the implications of this in real life are. You know, possibly 1 in 10 people or vegans or whatever who are taking injections of B12 could be walking around with acne from their injections. That's something that's good to know. The high dose pills are very unclear, but theoretically, there's no reason to be worried from taking a slightly lower dose. And then that way, if it is causing it, then it wouldn't be causing it. And from those earlier studies, we see that it clears up quite quickly. So if someone wanted to test this, it'd be pretty easy. And I want to mention, I've known about the study for quite a while. I've briefly mentioned it in other videos, but I put off doing a whole video about it because I didn't want to make people afraid of taking B12. So it's very clear that people should still be following the going recommendation by virtually all plant-based doctors to be taking B12. It's just a matter of the dose. Like, the injections, probably completely pointless. And to echo this, one of the main authors spoke to Live Science and cautioned that it's way too early to suggest people dealing with acne should stop taking multivitamins with B12. Lowering the dose is another conversation. Getting rid of injections, to me, a no-brainer. But I would really like to see a study of like 100 people given high dose oral B12 and another 100 people doing the injections, just see what the rates really are, see if we pick anything up with that high dose B12 or not. In the end, there's definitely something real here. We can see in that rare case of someone taking a high dose injection having that trigger acne sort of imbalance. Now, we don't know the threshold, but we're talking in the tens of thousands of picograms for those injections versus probably not breaking 1,000 for taking high dose B12, so who knows? So for the few people out there who have acne and are taking B12 injections, I hope this video helped and I hope that you can clear that up. And also, if anybody gets curious and has one of those black lights and looks at their face, let us know down below in the comments what you see. I find all this facial science stuff super interesting. If you did too, feel free to like the video and subscribe if you haven't already, notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.